As we started this chapter, Penamukuru, a village in Krishna Delta, and we continued this chapter in the previous class up to the orchards, the Penamukuru villagers, what do they produce, how do they live, what water facilities do they have, how they cultivate their lands, how they irrigate their lands, those things we studied. Let us see in the today's class, irrigation, market and changing crops, land ownership, tenancy in the Penamukuru village, houses, what type of houses are located in Penamukuru village, poultry and their daily livelihoods. And in poultry, different types of the milk where they will sell, and the animality, how it is available. Let us see these things in today's class. Irrigation and market changing crops. We have seen that there is a shift from the growing food grains like the millets, paddy, and pulses to cash crops like the sugarcane, vegetables, fruits and the turmeric. This is made possible by the growth of the irrigation, as these crops need a lot of water. The availability of loans of the purchase, other inputs like seeds and fertilizers is another contributing factor, but these crops mainly it needed lot of water. And it had in the Penamukuru village. In Penamukuru village, there is a lot of water. There is a lot of water facility because a flood low dipped area where is located is a delta. Penamukuru village, which is located in delta region, so that was the facility here to produce this crop, where this crop is required lot of amount of the water also. Let us see land ownership and tenancy. How many people are taking the land with tenancy, with rent, the land taking by rent and cultivating, how many families and how many people have the own land, that we see land ownership and tenancy. There are about 750 families in the Penamukuru. There are how many families in the Penamukuru? 750 families in the Penamukuru. 10 of them have the 10 acres of land or above. 10 of them have. Only 10 families only have the about 10 acres land. Approximately 150 families have land below 5 acres, and the rest have no land, which means 10 families have 10 acres of land, 150 families have below 5 acres land or 5 acres land, which means only 160 families have some amount of the land, more and less. But what about remaining, what about 590 families has to depend on the another works, groceries, drivers, kirana shops, milk vendors, different works remaining families we do, that we can expect, as it is only given in the lesson also. So they either take land on else from the landlords or work as the laborers on their farms. Suppose other families who does not have land in that village, they have to work as the laborers, or they have to take land as in the tenancy from the people who have the 10 acre land. So only 10 families have the 10 acres of the land. Otherwise, they have to work as the work laborers. Otherwise, they have to do other works. See, this was the condition of the Penamukuru village. Only 10 families have the 10 acre land and 150 families have the 5 acres and below 5 acres land. So this was the land facility where the Penamukuru villagers have, which means majority part of the villagers, nearly 590 families, they do not have any land to till and cultivate. And houses, next title here comes, houses. What type of houses have, in what type of houses they live? Are they living in the RCC buildings, like constructed houses, or are they living in the huts? That we can see in this passage. People of the different castes and the professions live in this village. Different castes and different professions, different professions live in this village. The main village is inhabited by the landlords. The others live in the nearby areas. Nearby areas on the banks of the canal and towards south and the village. In the middle of the village, we can find kirana shops, bank, RMP, which means RMP doctors. What does RMP stands for? Registered Medical Practitioner. So RMP doctors also located in this village, in the middle of the village. Iron welding shops, hair salon, tiffin centers, etc. are the other professions. The families who do not have any other professions, like 590 family, 590 families do not have the land, their families are included in these professions. Animal rearing, all lands in the village are cultivated and there is no much land for grazing cattle, hence only a few bullocks, cow, buffaloes and the sheep are reared for the working on the fields and for other purposes. How do we think would they feed the animals, which means where they have the little amount of the agriculture land, or for the animal grazing purpose they will keep some tilled land to cultivate to feed the buffaloes and other animals like sheep, what they are feeding in the village. Basket weaving and pig rearing and the fishing also one of the profession in this village. On the banks of the Bandar canal live 15 to 20 basket weaving families. They migrate to this village from work. Their main occupation are making baskets and catching rats and rearing pigs. And Jagannath Manchuraya settled here about 30 years ago. He collects date palm and strands from the banks and canals and making the baskets, which means he collects the date palms and with the date palms, when that date palms get dry, at that time he weaves the baskets with that date palm stems, that we can say that here. And the canal, bank of the canal for the making of the baskets, he and his wife make 5-6 baskets per day and sell them in the nearby village. Their neighbors, Kattashivaya, catches the fishes and with the help of the basket drops and sells them in the nearby villages. Let us see, this was the story which was given in the Penmakur village, where the two people example is given, and Shivaya and Nancharaya, how they are living with the different professions because they do not have any facility to feed their families. Poultry, the village has a fully mechanized poultry farm. Water is supplied to the nipple and the food is supplied by the conveyors. So there are about 80,000 hens in the poultry, laying about the 50,000 eggs each day. How many eggs they are laying? 80,000 hens are living in that poultry and 50,000 eggs are laying by that hens. These eggs are sent to the Vijayawada and other states like Assam and Bihar through agents, which means the agents will come to these farms and they will supply to the Vijayawada these eggs as into the various types of the markets. The chicken dropping is sold as fish feed to the farmers in the nearby areas, which means the several agents, several merchants will come and sell these things to the other areas where these things are in needs and where these things are not available, that we can expect here. And the farmers who are the 10 acres of the land, the farmers who are the 5 acres of the land, the farmers, what they will produce, as we studied in the previous passages, they produce as rice and different categories, and the in this village rice mills also available, the farmers who are cultivating rice, the who are producing maize, rice, they comes to with the, by taking their millets to this rice mill to the separate husk from the rice. So that we can see in this village rice mill, there is a rice mill in this village. The owner of this rice mill purchases paddy from the peasants and prepares rice to sell into other places. Poultry and rice mills are based on the agriculture and therefore are called agro industries. They are a common features in the plains. It is easy to get the necessary raw materials and transport the produce to the distant markets. They sell these products into the distant markets where the rice mill separates the husk from the paddy, and paddy husk when some, from the paddy when the husk was separated, it becomes rice and it supplies to the markets. Road transports and the markets. The road network in this region is well developed, providing the connectivity to many towns and cities. This helps in the marketing the produce. The farmers of this village sell the sugarcane to nearby sugar factory, which is located at Uyur. Where is the sugar factory? Is located to the sugar farmer, sugar producing farmers. Sugar factory is located in the Uyur village, which is connected with the road network of that village only. The vegetables and the bananas are supplied to the Raitu Bazaar, which is in Uyur and the Vijayawada. The paddy is sold in the fields itself through the brokers, which means everywhere the traders are located. Traders will purchase from the brokers and the brokers are selling it into the Raitu Bazaars and markets. Availability of the labor. Most villagers are employed in this village itself. Some agricultural laborers also come from the surrounding villages. The youth who study at 10th or above are working as electricians, auto drivers or mechanics. The different in the different professions, the different people are doing in this village. The people who studied up to 10th class, they are working as the auto drivers, mechanics, and as they are working as drivers, they are doing the different professions as they do not have the correct amount of the employment opportunity. So they are included in the all service sector employments. As we can see, a village which is available, which has the full of water facility, which is which compared here, which village is located in the delta and which village has a lot of amount, and that villagers, their habitual activities, how they are feeding, in what profession they are being, where they are selling, these all the examples are given in the story of this lesson. We will continue the next chapter, fourth chapter, given Dokur, a village on the plateau. Here Penamakuru, a village which is located in delta. And next village we are going to start in the next session is Dokur, a village on the plateau. So we will continue Dokur, a village on the plateau, in next session. Do complete third chapter. Note down all the question answers, one mark questions, and improve your learning questions in your fair notes. Thank you.